Hey everyone, Rarity Dash here. Time for another Patreon sponsor, Blind Reaction. And this one comes to you courtesy of the Doctor, who has requested that I react to the first part of the album Hozier by the group of the same name. And I'm not sure I'm saying that right. Hozier. It's probably not that last one, but it's H-O-Z-I-E-R. So I really am not sure I'm supposed to say that, because I've never heard of these guys. I don't know what I'm getting into here. Don't think I've heard anything from them, but I could always be wrong. I mean, familiar stuff has crept into these reactions where I was pretty sure I wasn't familiar with them before. Yeah, I'm not aware. I should just say that. I'm not aware of them. And not really even sure what kind of music this is going to be. But I'm very interested to find out. So let's go ahead and get this started. And here we go. My lover's got humor. She's a giggle at a funeral. Okay, interesting sound. Definitely different from the kind of stuff I've been doing. If the heavens ever did speak, she's the last true mouthpiece. Every Sunday's getting more bleak. Fresh poison each week. We were born sick, you heard them say it. My church offers no absolutes. She tells me worship in the bedroom. The only heaven I'll be sent to is when I'm alone with you. I was born sick, but I love it. Command me to be well. Amen. Amen. Interesting. Oh, I've heard this chorus before. Was this used in like an ad or something? This sounds familiar. Very good chorus. This very unique. I'm not even sure what you would call this style. Very interesting. To the point where I'm not really sure what to say about it. And the chorus is catchy as hell. Despite being kind of dark, I would say. And the whole feel of the song is kind of dark. It has a very interesting sound to it, and the drums, I think, were pretty strong. Very driving. Well, good start. Very, very intrigued to see what these guys got after that. What else they've got, I mean. I watch the work of my bold and boyful, toying somewhere between love and abuse. He's got a pretty cool voice. Yeah, very emotive. There we go. It's kind of folky in a way. Fun. Oh, that's nice. Very smooth. I like the combination of styles. Though it probably makes them kind of hard to classify. That bluesy rock guitar, that's... Good lyric. She's gonna save me, call me baby from her head to my head. She'll know me crazy, soothe me daily, but yet she wouldn't care. Okay, cool. Lord, it'd be great to find a place we could escape sometime. I like this. Me and my eyes is growing black irises in the sunshine. With every version of me dead and buried in the yard outside. Sit back and watch the world go by. Happy to lie back. Watch it burn and rust. We tried the world, good God, it wasn't for us. She's gonna save me, call me baby from her edge of my head. She'll know me crazy, suit me daily, but yet she wouldn't care. Yeah, very cool. Jackie Wilson. Cut clean from the dream at night, let my mind reset. Looking up from a cigarette, and she's already left. Started digging up the art for what's left of me in our little vignette. But whatever poor soul is coming next, she's gonna save me, call me baby, from her head to my head. She'll know me crazy, to me daily, but yet she wouldn't care. Very nice. I think that might actually be my favorite one so far. Just, I like the lyric there. I guess musically it wasn't quite as catchy, but I liked what they were going for with it. I think they achieved it. Gonna take this the wrong way. This one has a much more chill feel than everything so far. Every step that I ran to you, only blue or black days. Electing strange perfections in any stranger I choose. Would things be easier if there was a right way? Honey, there is no right way. So I fall in love just a little or a little bit. Every day with someone new, I fall in love. Yeah, this is very interesting music. Definitely feels like a throwback. It's kind of like a Van Morrison vibe, I would say. I like it. Somehow escape the burning way, the art of scraping through. Some like to imagine the dark caress of someone else, I guess any thrill. Things be easier if there was a right way, honey. There is no right way. And so I fall in love just a little or a little bit every day with someone. I fall in love just a little or a little bit every day with someone. I fall in love just a little or a little bit every day with someone. I fall in love just a little or a little bit every day. First cringe of morning, and my heart's already sinned. How pure, how sweet the love beneath the head. You would pray for him, 'cause God knows I fall just a little or a little bit every day with someone new. I fall in love just a little or a little bit every day with someone new. Every day with someone new. I fall in love just a little or a little bit. Every He likes those background vocals in there. But like background choir. That was on the first track as well. I mean, a lot of repetition there, but it's it's pretty catchy. Pretty good stuff. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Sucker for that. Very bluesy. Another very dark track here. Cool. I like the vocalizations. Nice wordless chorus. Very dark feel to some of these lyrics and just the sound of it.
It feels good, girl, it feels good. It feels good.
kind of a haunting note to end on there. Just the isolated vocal. I'm guessing that's not a simple love song. But maybe it is. I don't know. Maybe the sound is deceiving. Back to something a bit more bright. This sounds very Van Morrison. Look at this instrumental part. A lot going on there. The strings and the... I like it when it just kind of hangs there. We're using the... using silence well. Thank you. pretty start. She has a pretty voice. Guest vocalist, I guess. So, yeah, song about death. Yeah, he definitely, there are darker sensibilities here than you would expect from this kind of music usually. If you don't listen to the lyrics, this is a very pretty song. I mean, it's still pretty, but it's kind of morbid. I have never known sleep like this. Who is this? That creeps to me. I'll look up the album afterwards. Very curious to actually do that and learn more about these guys, but your hand in my hand, so still and discreet. So long we'd become the flowers. We'd feed well the land and worry the sheep. And they'd find us in a leap. When the cattle show. This is really good. Definitely one of my favorites. After foxes have known our taste, I'd be home with you. I'd be home with you. They'd find us in a week or for hours. Oh. That vocal. Vocal interplay. Harmony. After the foxes have known our taste, after the raven has had its say, I'd be home with you. 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 Melody too. Yeah, that was really cool. we got one more for this part. Great line. Anyway, to distract and sedate. He's a pretty good lyricist in general, I would say. Or whoever's writing it. I don't know. You and I, nursing all the poison that bear the stub, our teeth and lungs aligned with the scum of it. Somewhere for this, death and guts, we are death, we are numb. Somewhere outside my life, babe, I keep scratching, but somehow I can't get in. So it slaves to any semblance of touch. Lord, we should quit, but we love it too much. This is probably my favorite lyric so far. Yeah, that was really good. Good one to end on for now. had a really cool sound to it, some great lyrics. Just a straight-ahead good song there. So yeah, very interesting stuff here. These guys are certainly quite unique. I mean, it's... the closest comparison point I do feel is like something like Van Morrison. It has a very... throwbacky kind of classic rock type thing to it, but it also has like darker, more modern sensibilities thrown in there too, so it's together kind of like something just that I've never heard before. So I don't know, I'm very interested to learn about them, but let's see. Hozier. See. Oh. Okay, so it's not really a band. It's that's his stage name. Andrew John Hozier. Oh, it's actually part of his name. Andrew John Hozier Bearn. I guess if it is part of your name, that definitely is the most interesting part of his name, so might as well go with it. Hozier. Okay, so I was saying it kind of close. Hozier. I don't know. Is an Irish musician. Yeah, I mean, Something about it seemed quite Irish. It's definitely like Van Morrison. The Jackie Wilson thing, just that Blue Eyes Sold type sound that was kind of thrown in there, that's kind of stuff really, it definitely struck a chord with Ireland, and definitely made a more lasting impression there than a lot of places, so I'm not surprised to learn he's Irish. Though the voice, I mean, he didn't really sing with an accent, but yeah. Irish musician, singer, and songwriter from County Wicklow. He had his international breakthrough after releasing his debut single, Take Me to Church. Okay, so yeah, the lead off here, which definitely I can see why that would be an actual success, like an actual legit. It just had a great chorus, and I can see why that would take off. Debut EP, debut studio album, topped the chart in Ireland, and scored top 10 positions on global charts. So yeah, he's doing well. And he's had a second album this year, so that's cool. So yeah, well, let's look at the album. His debut, obviously, I mean, being the eponymous one. Well received by music critics and commercially successful. Good. I mean, it was good music. This is good stuff. This is like classic good music, and it's genre that Wikipedia lists as blues, soul, R&B, folk, indie rock. Yeah, I mean, I hear all that. Yeah, it's definitely a combination of things. Depending on the song you're listening to, really, he's just trying these different styles, and it's pretty neat. And we listened up to track 8, Sedated, and then Take Me to Church. What was that used in? Is that like used in an ad? Where do I know that from? Well, it's used in a lot of stuff. See if there's anything a lot of covers. Not seeing anything I know, though. I guess it's just something I passively absorbed without realizing it, just because it was a big song. I mean, it did go, looking at the charts, it went as far as number 2 on the Billboard Hot 100, and it went pretty high up on most of the charts, so this was a pretty big deal song, so I guess I could see how that could happen, that I would just know it without really knowing where I know it from. I don't know, but yeah, good song, very, very strong chorus, and it got a kind of anti-church message to it, seems, which makes sense. I mean, it's obviously, with the dark feel to it, it's not going to be really having a positive, it's not really positive towards the church that it's talking about. There we go. And after that, we had Angel of Small Death and the Coding Scene. Okay, that's interesting. I probably should have paid more attention to the lyrics on that one. But that was a good song. Jackie and Wilson, really like that one, just the feel for it. The second one was like a folky one. Like, it really had that folk feel emphasized. And then we kind of went to the, yeah, old time Blue Eyed Soul and the Yeah, that was a good one. Someone New. I forget what that one was. I think I liked it though. And that was another single. To Be Alone. I don't know. It was all good. I mean, I liked everything. Just like the moments that really stand out. I mean, the one with the featuring Karen Callie, apparently. That was really beautiful. That was definitely a standout. And then the final one, I liked that a lot too, and that was another single. Yeah, that was really good. So cool. And yeah, just a very interesting, this is definitely different music from what you guys would normally what you guys have been requesting. So I mean, you guys are free to request anything, of course, but it's been a lot of metal, a lot of more that kind of stuff, and this is closer to what I'd listen to on my own, I feel. Maybe not quite there, but yeah, this was really something I could definitely appreciate. It does give me those classic feel, and real classic vibe to it, and just a lot of interesting combination of genres, and yeah, he's definitely very, very talented. I mean, he just knowing like, what did he do? He did well, obviously vocals, and did he write all his songs? Yes, he did. One of them had a co-writer, but everything else he wrote himself. So he's very talented just as a singer-songwriter, but he also played guitar, bass, piano, and synthesizer. So just a talented multi-instrumentalist too. So that's impressive, because there was the piano especially was great throughout, and so was the guitar. I mean, when it came in, wasn't there prominent on everything, but when it was there, when we decided to make it a bit more rock, he pulled it off pretty well. And the synths, just everything. He was pretty good bass lines too. I mean, I don't really pay too much attention to that typically, but I think, thinking back, I mean, that's how we kind of get that darker feel and all that stuff. So definitely a real talent here. I'm glad he actually found commercial success. This is the kind of stuff that could very often slip through the cracks, but I guess all you need is like a really good earworm to kind of get you in there. And that first song, it has that with that chorus. So, very, very impressed by this. Good stuff. And, we'll see. I mean, we'll see if the patron requests the rest. I would definitely be happy to listen to it, because this was really good. Anyway, hope you liked the reaction. Let me know if you did, and see you in the next one.